Here we are at the Hits Live backstage bar with James Arthur.
All right.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Great. You smell amazing, by the way. Can we please discuss what is that?
It's Louis Vuitton.
Is it like a mixture of your natural odor and then just a hint of Louis Vuitton?
It might be. I think my natural odor is quite nice.
It's special.
Thanks. Yeah.
It's doing things.
Thank you. Good.
I appreciate it.
I'm glad about that.
Thanks for making an effort.
Always.
So you're going out to a sold out arena.
Can't comfy on this chair, like.
Yeah, I know.
Why.
I can see you.
Sort of struggling.
The struggle's real.
It's a real struggle. I think I'm in. I'm good.
Like our bar, by the way?
Yes, yeah, cool. It's
There's
nice
something
bar.
You change about it. Maybe the seats.
You could have forked out a bit more on the seats.
Next year.
It's not really one for a big
fluffy
lad.
Seat. So you're about to go out to a sold out arena.
Yeah.
What do you do to prep and get ready for a massive show?
Just try and stay as calm as possible, me. Mm. I just try and just chill out and, just stay as zen as possible. Because no matter how you prepare, no matter what sort of ritual you go through, the adrenaline's going to hit you either way. So you can be asleep. I could be asleep 5 minutes before a gig and then I get backstage and that thing hits you. So I think the more calm you can be before that, adrenaline dump is probably a good thing, or at least works for me. I don't like to overthink it too much.
Yeah, do you still get nervous? Because people are always surprised when someone like you performs so much, still gets nervous?
Yeah, of course, yeah. It's always different, I think. It's always really different. Like, shows like this, you've got a great lineup, and I'm last on the bill, so I don't know if that means that people are expecting more.
Special.
A more of a show from me or something. So, yeah, I just try, yeah. A little bit, yeah. I still get a bit nervous, yeah.
That means that you care.
I still care. I'm still not, I haven't quite died inside yet.
Yeah, exactly.
My soul is still somewhat still there.
The fire is still burning.
Yeah.
I like it. What's on your rider? What's your rider saying?
My rider, what do I have on my rider?
I want to know. Tell me the truth.
Well, it's not the full rider today. I've got to say, the Hits Live team haven't put those kiddings. I have quite weird things on my rider, stuff that people wouldn't expect, like tofurkey, which is like a plant-based protein. I have that on there. I have Tabasco in case the catering's not too good. That'll always
hot sauce saves the day.
But
always.
Yeah, hot sauce will save the day in any situation. So yeah, I always have that. we just have a few plant-based things because I'm vegan, so. It's sometimes hard to get something vegan in some places, so I make sure that I've got an option there.
How long have you been vegan for?
A couple of years now.
Oh, nice.
I've grappled with cheese on occasion. Occasionally, to all the vegans out there, like once or twice I've slipped up, and it's usually been after a couple of drinks or something. So, yeah, but on the whole, I'm pretty good vegan.
Okay, nice. Golden vegan.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah.
So your album, You. Yeah. It's about stories from your fans and like people you know, inspired by that, right?
Yeah.
So does it make it really special when you're singing the songs?
Yeah, I mean, it's the thing about my last album was very much about me. It was very autobiographical, and when I was selling the album, it didn't allow me to get much personality across because I was just constantly talking about my wars and my pain that I've been through, and it was like, James Arthur's dull. He's just talking about all of the stuff he's gone through, and on this one, like. Yeah, it just means it's a bit more lighthearted. I kind of went with the approach to be inspired by other people and not be so introverted. You know what I mean?
I like that.
What else? Self-indulgent. That's.
I mean, your voice is just incredible.
Thank
what are you doing
so
to
jealous.
Look after the vocal cords?
Help
a sister out. What are you doing?
Yeah, I think you're fine. I do a lot of lip trills.
Ah.
That's my thing. Yeah.
So like
a lot of that sort of yeah, a lot of that. Yeah, that was terrible. That was a feeble attempt. it's cool. Yeah. A lot of lip trilling and being hydrated. Very boring.
No, that's good. I just always like to know if there's anything special you do.
Well, I never really looked after my voice until last year when I cancelled a few gigs. I was gutted about it, and I was like, "Well, I'm gonna have to manage it a little bit better than I am. I can't be doing the things I was doing." So, I figured it out. started doing lip trills.
Well, the trills are working. Whatever you're doing is working.
Trill Crosby.
So you performed Quiet Miss Home on X Factor Celebrity.
Yeah.
What was that like? What do you think of the show? Like who do you think is going to win?
I think Megan McKenna will win.
So do I.
Yeah, she's really good. She's like a country vibe, isn't it?
Yes.
And she's really good at it. She's legit, so I think she'll win.
What do you think of the concept, like having celebrities in a competition?
I don't know, really. I haven't really caught too much of it, but I think what's interesting to me is that they seem to want it as much as the civilian X Factor, if you want to call it that. The one we were on, they seem to want it almost as much. And
that's quite surprising, isn't it, really?
Yeah, considering they've already sort of achieved a level of fame and notoriety, like they feel like this is going to give them the thing that they've always wanted. So,
well, your fans have been sending us questions for you.
Yeah.
So I've got some of their questions.
What are they saying?
Emma Clare asks, if you weren't a singer, what job would you want to do?
If I wasn't a singer, I don't know. I'd be probably be on the Dole.
Love it.
Probably be on the Dole.
The realest answer.
I'll be back on the rock and roll, I think.
That just means that singing is just you.
This is my
you were
thing,
born
yeah.
to do this. It's
performing, yeah.
Somewhere. I love it. Amy Booth asks, would you like to do the John Lewis advert song one year?
Who wouldn't? It's probably a lot of money, isn't it?
Right.
Yeah.
But your voice would be incredible. You could have done
it's
this
not
year's
about the
one.
Money. I was joking. that would have been cool. I don't know how it works. Like, do people audition?
No. Like, do you audition? Like, do you send a demo into Mr. John Lewis?
I have no idea. Who is there a man called John Lewis somewhere?
What would actually be your dream job, like, as a singer? Something you'd always love to do?
Doing something like that would be cool. Something iconic like that, or like a soundtrack. Oh, at least it's not too loud back there.
Yeah.
So we're not trying to do an interview or out.
Sabaloy.
I was kidding. I don't know, like a James Bond theme tune or something would be cool. Like, you mean just something a bit different? I don't know, something like that. I'd just like to, at this point in my career, I've written a love song that's going to stand the test of time. It's one of only a few songs to get a billion streams, and it's like a song that people have made part of their weddings and things like that. So I feel like I've proved myself in that field, and like I don't really want to do any more of that. I feel like I'm getting known as being this balladeer cat, and you know, my fans know that I do a lot more. I like to do hip hop and I do rock.
I mean, you can throw down some bars as well.
I can spit some bars. I could do a few different things, and it's like it's a bit frustrating sometimes when people think I'm just this like depressing love song guy.
But so you do it so well.
Thank you.
So it's fine.
But yeah, it's fine. It's definitely not. It's definitely nothing to complain about. But my goal now is to make a song that achieves somewhere near that success that's not in that world, and you know. Get into a bit of a passion project, I think.
Oh, I like it. I'll be looking out for that. Max asks, what's the most expensive thing you've ever bought?
The most expensive thing I've ever bought was probably I bought my mum a house. And that was expensive.
Oh, James.
Yeah.
That's so cute.
My mum and my sisters, I bought them a house. They live there up north. So
nice. Oh, see, that's lovely. I love that about you. Kirsty asks, what's your biggest guilty pleasure?
My biggest guilty pleasure is probably like 80s rock ballads. I like
really?
Yeah. Like there's a Bryan Adams song called I Thought I Died and Gone to Heaven.
Oh yeah.
It's a big tune that. And I will often
big tune.
Big tune, yeah. And I'll listen to that sometimes when no one's around.
Mm-hmm. And just sing it like at the top of your voice.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. And like just hope that no one ever sees that.
Let's hope no one sees that. Amy Johnson's asking this question. I kind of want to know, because I've been on the show. Would you ever go on I'm a Celebrity?
On I'm a Celebrity? I wouldn't say no. I wouldn't say no to it. I don't know if I could put a spider in my mouth, though.
Yeah. What would be your trigger? Like, what would make you say the dreaded words, I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here?
Just putting, like, a kangaroo's piece in my mouth or something, or, like, I don't know, like... I mean, actually, that's not too bad. Like, that's all right. It's just... I actually don't agree with, like, a lot of the... A few of the things that they do.
I mean, it's hard for a vegan to go into the jungle.
I'm not going to get too, like, animal rights on it, but It is. Some of it, yeah, does makes me a bit uncomfortable, so I would have to see.
What's your biggest fear, though? What would be like, oh, no.
Biggest fear? I reckon being, like, covered in rats or something, or covered in, like, snakes, some of that. I think I'd be all right. I'd get through it, because I'd be very much for the camp, you know what I mean? I'd be very, like...
You're a team player.
I'm a team player, big time, but the thought of being in, like, a dark hall with a lot of creatures around me freaks me out.
Yeah, it's not great.
Yeah.
So let's move on to something a bit happier. Christmas is coming.
Crimbo is coming.
What are you like with your shopping? Are you literally Christmas Eve shopping, or are you doing it like weeks in advance?
It's quite. I cut it quite fine, but I'm. I love it. I like to buy a lot of Christmas presents. I've got loads of sisters, and I like to branch out, and I go too far, way too far.
Do you really?
Yeah.
And what's the best present that you've like bought?
Oh my god! Like last Christmas, I went in the most. Like, I bought my dad a car, and like. Just watching.
You just really go all out, don't you?
Yeah, well, I look after my family. You know, it's been, life has been good to me, and I like to try and share it with my family. Just watching my dad open up the box and see he's got a key in it. Like that, those moments are cool. My little sister, I bought her a first car as well. So yeah, I like that feeling.
I need to find out if we're like related in some distant way, because I could do with a car.
I like that secret millionaire program. Have you ever seen that?
Yes.
I like that sort of vibe. I like doing that kind of thing. It's cool.
You're kind of like Santa in your own way, like sprinkling people.
I'm getting as fat as Santa as well. Been eating too much.
So what are you asking Santa for this year? You're giving out all the presents. What do you want for Christmas?
I don't know. Good health. Good health. That's it. That's all I want. That's it. That's
I
a bar.
Like it.
It's a pretty cliche answer, but
no, not really. Actually, it's actually quite a nice deep answer.
Yeah.
Do you have any Christmas traditions?
Crimbo traditions.
Anything quirky?
Christmas. We have an argument, probably. there's probably some sort of disagreement in my.
What are you like when the argument's going on? Are you like the mediator? You're a bystander.
I like a good debate. I like that.
You're in the thick of it.
Yeah, I like to get involved. Yeah.
Like to get involved.
I like to be a wooden spoon. Just keep it going.
You're stirring the trouble. Yeah. Stirring the pot. I've got a little game to play with
All right.
You know, we've been getting quite deep and spiritual, but now it's time for some fun. Kay. This is the quick draw.
Quick draw.
We're asking all of our artists here at Hits Live to draw a portrait of themselves.
Oh, no.
But you're on the clock. You've got 30 seconds to do it. We need to just find out, basically, which of our artists is the best artist.
Well, it's not going to be me. I'm gonna have to tell you.
I don't
know.
I mean, don't write yourself off too soon. So 30 seconds.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna ask you some questions while you're doing it as well.
All right.
To try and concentrate. Okay. No, I think you got this. Okay.
Ready?
3, 2, 1. Bam. Best country to visit.
Brazil.
Are you good at FIFA?
I'm the best.
Morning person or night owl?
Night owl.
How often do you work out?
At the moment, not at all, because I hurt my knee.
What's 7 times 5?
Don't know.
Have you ever written a poem?
Yeah.
Pirates or zombies?
Zombies.
Last film you watched?
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Favorite Disney princess?
Why have I put hair around my hat? Princess Jasmine.
Way! And that is it. Now, this is the part I love. Let's have a look at your masterpiece here. Wonderful.
Mozart.
That's definitely in the top three, I'd say.
Picasso.
So can you just talk us through what inspired this? So what are we looking at here?
So I felt a bit under pressure. So I went, I sort of like just tried to do the head shape as good as possible at the beginning. And then I went with the hair and then I remembered I had a hat on.
I love it.
And no chin.
Could you please?
Pretty accurate. Pretty accurate.
Can you please sign this wonderful masterpiece?
Yeah, I can do
here.
That. No problem.
Yes, James. Well, I cannot wait to see you perform.
Thank you.
I'll be watching side of stage.
Beautiful.
Thanks.
Thanks so much, Fleur.